Hello, I am Maud and welcome on Women Run the World podcast. The show where you can listen to unique interviews of female runners that I met during my run trip world from 2015 to 2017. You will listen to interviews with no filter to understand why women are running, how it's different to run in Cambodia, Kenya or Brazil. Let's go and meet all these women who run the world. Welcome on episode number 32 of Women Run the World podcast with Veronica interview. Veronica started to run late at the age of 40. This sport completely changed her mindset and gave her confidence. So she can do anything now. Let's listen to Veronica's story.
Hello.
Hi.
Could you tell me who you are and what is your athletic history?
Well, Veronica, that's my English name. History is really short, actually, because I'm a new runner. I just started since last August, not yet even 1 year. And honestly, I never ever think I could be a runner. When I was a kid, I'm not even able to run 800 meters. I'm dying for me. I hate the long distance running and I have zero stamina. And now I'm running like 30 kilometers a week, minimally 120 kilometers per month. And I'm preparing for my first marathon, which is going to be this September.
Nice. Could you tell me why did you begin to run?
Honestly, because physically I really feel like I must do some exercises, otherwise I'm dying from my heavy load of work. I'm working like 12 hours per day and I had a lot of traveling, business traveling, and I'm just stretching myself too much. 10 years ago, I'm okay. I'm fully energetic. I'm able to handle that. But after 35, I feel like no. Physically, you cannot catch up with the load. And I feel like I stay there 12 hours per day and there's no efficiency. And my boyfriend also gave me a good influence because he, although he's not very fit, but he's a runner for 10 years in a club called Hash Harry House. If you called it a running club with a drinking problem or drinking club with running problem. And then I started to run and I run over the world. This is really a good motivation. You find a nice place to run. You find fun when you run. You forget about the distance, you forget about toughness, and you just enjoy. So I run in every season, in winter, in a snow mountain, in summer, in desert, on beach, on mountain. It's fun. And in Shanghai, I have just daily routine run. It's a bit boring, of course, but it becomes necessary scenes of every day. If I don't run, I feel like physically I feel uncomfortable and mentally I feel like something missing. And of course, the Hash Harry House also I enjoyed it. It adds the fun. Although you probably the calories you gain after the running in the drinking already overtake the calorie you burn during the run.
Could you tell me if it's your full job now?
No, I really wish. Actually, in the past, I think I need the job basically to support economically, to support my life. And now I feel like financially, if I'm good enough to support myself, I wish I can make it a full-time job. But so far, I'm not yet ready for that. But I'm thinking, if one day I get bored by the work, I probably get retired early. I will focus on running and I would also like to find a job in the charity association, like take care of the stranded dogs or animals or whatever. Just do something meaningful.
Could you tell me if it's hard to be a woman in a running competition?
No, not at all.
Why?
Because I have a small boobs. I'm kidding. I don't really think there is some specific weakness of women being a runner. I think they can do the same as men. Okay, my fundamentally, my purpose of running is not to race, because I'm not in the age of racing. I'm already 40 years old this year. I'm just starting to run and enjoyed it. I'm also gradually improve my running pace. But still, for me, the physical exercises and the fun is more important. And I think this is nothing, has nothing to do with the gender.
And could you tell me if you have children?
No, I don't. And I do not have the plan to have.
It will be easier for you to train?
I think so. That's why I think, you know, when I started to run, I started to thinking, what the hell? I wasted my time. In the past, I have many excuses. Oh, no, I'm busy, I have no time to run. But that's all bullshit. If you want to run, you can always make the time. And now I feel like, okay, I don't have a kids to take care. I don't have many housework to do. Okay, I have a job, but after the work, I'm totally free. So if I have 1 hour, I have nothing to do, I will make use of it by running in any place.
So you carry all the time your running shoes with you?
Absolutely. This is a big problem because I have more things to carry in my luggage.
Could you tell me what is your best memory, even you started less than 1 year ago in running?
It's very difficult to say the best memory because I have so many nice memories. Well, the best memory in terms of distance, because it's the first time I pushed myself to 30 kilometers, was in Melbourne Beach. It was such a nice place that you're listening to music, running on the beach, you feel like you are flying, you catch up the cloud on the sky like a free bird, which makes you totally forget your tiredness. In terms of the fun of running, I like very much the running in January, in winter in Hokkaido in Japan. We are on the mountain where you have a big piece of the virgin snow land, because the snow was too deep and it was closed for any vehicles because of the snowing. And the tourists, they just don't want to bother to go to that area. So you're running on the mountain with the knee-deep snow to a virgin forest where there's nobody except you and your footprint. That feeling is really gorgeous.
Nice. Good memory.
It is.
Can you share something with me about running or something that you want to say to other women in the world?
Running is not really that difficult as you think. I know it's difficult to start, particularly for long distance running. Okay, if you say I probably cannot afford to travel around the world and find all the nice place to run, it doesn't matter. It's not about the place you run. It's about who with whom you're running and what you think when you are running. For me, it's a good way to release yourself, to release all the stress from the work, to forget about all the shits that you probably encountered during the life and the work. So it's just a way to relax. For me, running is a way to relax you from the tightness, from the load, from all the shits about the life. And don't push yourself, say like, I'm obliged to run today. No. If you like, you want to run, you go. If you don't like, don't do. But don't say, always look for excuse for yourself of not running.
Do you have a final thought that you want to share that we didn't talk about?
I want you to say, sometimes you never can discover your potential, like me. I wasn't a sportswoman, never, ever. And now I'm a big sport fan, I'm a big workout freak. I would never ever imagine that just back to like 5 years or 10 years ago. If you don't do, you never know what potential you have. So just make a try and you will discover a totally different you. Particularly for women, which gives you confidence, which makes you feel like I never feel as good as it is now. Whatever I achieved in work, in life, can never compare with the current achievements after you study do the sports. I feel like I'm happy to try this bikini. I'm happy to show people my body because it's nice. And when I talk, I feel like I'm full of confidence. It's not coming from the work, coming from the achievements of work, but because your status is totally different.
Nice. Thank you very much for sharing this with me. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is it for now. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Veronica encouraged all women to practice sports and running, not only for the body, but for the mind. If you like this episode, send me some comments and some stars, and let's give more visibility to women who run around the world. See you on my next episode. Bye!